Good morning. In this video session, we are going to learn primary treatment of water with the help of sedimentation, coagulation, and aeration process from the unit water technology. This is the learning outcome for today's session. At the end of this session, students will be able to write definition of sedimentation, coagulation, aeration, and also able to describe treatment of water by aeration process. This is the content of today's session. First, we will learn the definitions of the term sedimentation, coagulation, aeration of water, and then we will learn the different types of aerators. Now, what is mean by sedimentation? So, sedimentation is a process of removing suspended impurities from water by keeping it undisturbed in the tanks so that suspended impurities may settle down at the bottom due to the force of gravity. So sedimentation is the removal of suspended impurities from a given sample of water with the help of gravitational force of attraction. It is generally carried out in sedimentation tank. For this, three types of tanks are used, such as rectangular tank, circular tank, and hopper bottom tank. Particularly, suspended impurities causes contamination of water, and so water loses the quality and it becomes unfit for domestic as well as industrial use. This is the tank that is vertical flow hopper bottom tank. In this diagram, it is shown that the raw water we are taking in a tank and we are not disturbing the water sample, under the influence of gravitational force, the considerable size of suspended impurities get settled at the bottom and the supertent water is collected after removal of suspended impurities with the help of sedimentation. Now this is about coagulation. This is applicable for removal of very fine and colloidal impurities from a water sample. Therefore, a process of removing very fine and colloidal particles completely and rapidly by the addition of some certain chemicals called as coagulants. This process is known as coagulation. What is the difference in between sedimentation and coagulation? Sedimentation is applicable for the removal of considerable sized particles, because there we are removing the particle only under the influence of gravitational force. But what about the particles who are having very, very negligible size, such as 1 micron to 1 millimicron size particles are there? Easily, such particles will not get settled even under the gravitational force of attraction. Therefore, such fine particles are settled at the bottom of the vessel by using certain chemicals called as coagulants. So, a process of removing very fine and colloidal impurities with the help of coagulants is known as coagulation. This is the diagram for coagulation, where from one end we are taking the raw water and then we are mixing the coagulant. There is a reaction, so coagulant binds several particles together. And as a result of that, there is an increase in weight of particles, and so the particle settles at the bottom of the water sample. Now we'll come to aeration. What is aeration? Aeration is the treatment process for water sample consisting of objectionable odor, color, and taste. The water sample acquires odor, color, and taste because of contamination of water with organic impurities. Aeration process improves the level of dissolved oxygen in a water sample, and as a result of that, the pollutants or impurities gets removed. So this process is called as aeration. Now what is the definition of aeration? Aeration is the process of bringing water in intimate contact with air so that water is able to absorb oxygen. Any procedure by which oxygen is added to water can be considered a type of water aeration. Along with the absorption of oxygen, aeration is also aimed removal of carbon dioxide, removal of H2S and removal of volatile impurities from a water sample. Therefore, aeration is mainly designed for absorbing a sufficient amount of atmospheric oxygen inside the water sample. Also, it is designed for the removal of carbon dioxide, H2S and the volatile impurities. Now here, I would like to ask you one question. Aeration of water removes option A, carbon dioxide, option B, objectionable color, option C, objectionable odor, and option D, all of these. What is the question? Ki aeration of water removes. What it removes actually? Think about that for a moment. The correct answer is option D, all of these. Because aeration removes carbon dioxide also, objectionable color and odor. Therefore, the correct answer is that all of these. Now we'll learn the different types of aerators. There are three main aerators. One is gravity aerators, second one is spray aerators, and third one is diffused aerators. Now, what is gravity aerators? There are two types of gravity aerators. One is cascade aerators. In this type, water is allowed to fall over a series of concrete steps in the form of thin film. During the fall, the water gets thoroughly mixed with the atmospheric oxygen and gets aerated. This is called as cascade aerators, where we are allowing the water to flow from a series of concrete steps in the form of thin film. Now, the second subtype is perforated trough aerators. In this method, the water is allowed to flow on the trickling beds of coke, which are supported on the perforated bottoms. The water is allowed to trickle from the top to the bottom under gravitational force. During this downward journey, each molecule of the water is in intimate contact with atmospheric oxygen, and in this way, the water gets efficiently aerated and it shows the sufficient amount of the dissolved oxygen inside the water sample. This is perforated. The both aerators are shown here with the help of diagram. So the first one is cascade type of aerator, and the second one is a perforated type of aerator. Now the second type of aerator is spray aerators. Spray or surface aerators, which sprays the water into the atmosphere with the help of nozzle. When we are forcing the water in an atmosphere, again each and every molecule of water is in intimate contact with atmospheric oxygen. And it is also one of the effective method of aeration, where we are flowing the water in the form of a fine drops with the help of nozzles into atmosphere. This is the diagram of spray aerator. We can see here, from this end we can supply the water, and from this perforation water will get sprayed in atmosphere, and this is also one of the effective method of aeration. Now the third one is diffusion aerators. Most diffusion aerators bubble compressed air into water through nozzle. So how the aeration is carried out in diffusion aerators? It is applicable for a large quantity of wastewater. So instead of that, water is kept at a stationary level and a perforated pipe is introduced into the water sample. And to one end, it is connected to compressor. And when the compressed air is passed through a perforated pipe, it gets bubble in the water sample. And in this way, the water gets aerated. And as a result of that, the objectionable gaseous impurities gets removed, and the sufficient oxygen will get dissolved in a water sample. So this is about diffusion aerators. Now what are the advantages of aeration? Aeration removes carbon dioxide up to 70%. Certain bacteria are killed to some extent because of aeration. Because we know that there are two types of bacteria, aerobic and anaerobic. So particularly when the oxygen is less, anaerobic type of bacteria will be more active, and such bacteria are killed to some extent when the oxygen will come in a good range. So the second type of advantage is that ki bacteria are killed to some extent. Iron and manganese are removed by oxidation, and also it removes H2S and organic matter from a water sample. So all these slides are prepared by using a textbook of engineering chemistry written by Jain and Jain. Thank you.